Things are going really well right now. It's just such a blessing to have Rob here. His history in construction and his experience being here. And I mean,
his laid-back approach is really bringing a lot of harmony to this tribe. I mean, we're just, might as well call it Camp Harmony right now.
It just gives me a certain peace knowing I'm not out here by myself, you know? Like, I was praying that God would, like, put me in an alliance, like the one that He kind of wanted me to be in. I'm pretty thrilled.
Me too.
You're so hardcore. I need to come hang out in Wisconsin.
Will you?
Yeah.
Second person voted out of Survivor Redemption Island. Matt.
Good work, guys. My goodness. Damn, guys.
I feel sick to my stomach right now. Like, it really hurts. I mean, there's a little anger. I don't know. I guess I just trusted Boston too soon.
Crazy.
I felt like such a goober now because I look like an idiot because everything was great at camp and everyone was really getting along and then wah. This is brutal. Definitely hard to come here and try to pick yourself up after you've been as blindsided as I was.
But at the same time, what an opportunity
to become the underdog and come back from Redemption Island and finish this game with $1 million.
Matt, what's going through your head right now?
It's do or die time, so like I'm ready to go. I mean, it's going to be the greatest underdog story if I get blindsided by my tribe with none of my stuff except for what I have on and come back all the way and make it to the end.
Matt has the third lock open. Matt stays alive.
Russell Hans just walked into my camp. I figured I'd see him sooner or later, but first off, man, that's a bit of a surprise. Russell Hans is definitely the biggest villain in Survivor history, hands down. But I'm fighting to honor my God, and because I want it so deeply and so truly, I think I'm gonna come out on top.
Matt stays alive! Matt, you survived another duel, my friend. Out of nowhere, Matt stays alive!
Can you pray a lot?
Oh yeah, man, I've been doing whatever I can. I really feel like God put me here.
Krista came in tonight. I was pretty excited to see her at first, but I quickly realized that she is a firecracker and she is here for business.
You're not sneaking under the radar, Blondie. We give this day to you and this duel to you, Lord, and know that whatever the outcome is, that it will bring honor to you, Lord. And we just thank you so much for letting us be here together on Redemption Island, Lord, and help us to just carry on honoring you, Lord. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen.
Krista's different from the other competitors I've faced for one key reason, is just that both of us have really been struggling with not having a faith community and other believers to kind of lean on and talk with about our beliefs and how we feel. It certainly makes it a lot more difficult to compete with her. I definitely have a little anxiety about the possibility that this could be my last day.
Matt stays alive! Yeah.
He's a tough cookie, but...
Thank you so much.
What is that, Krista?
My luxury item. My Bible.
I don't have mine, and so she's kind enough to leave it with me.
Is that something the two of you guys shared?
Yeah. You know, Matt's an extremely strong believer, and I think, you know, that might be one of the reasons he's doing so well out there.
Krista left her Bible to me, and I can't explain how much that meant to me, because that book just breathes life. I can never thank her enough. Stephanie, she came in and her mouth was just going a mile a minute, and that's kind of annoying, and I'm ready to go to the duel right now. I really want to win this one, and I've told God that I'm going to stay out here as long as He wants me to be out here, and so I'm in it for the long haul.
For the fifth time, Matt stays alive. We'll live to see another day in this game. Philip, you've seen Matt compete twice now.
And I'm very impressed with Matt. In the old days of the samurai, they had something called the Bushido Code. It was what the samurai live by. What I've seen in you, you are truly a samurai warrior.
Thank you, Philip.
Tarita from the Zaptera tribe arrived at Mikasa on Redemption Island this evening. I was quite happy to see her because she doesn't appear to be too incredibly tough. I'm sort of thinking that Tarita might be the last of the duelers before the merge. I trust the information that she's been giving me about the Zaptera tribe.
Up until this point, I was saying that it'd be better for me to hop back on the train with Ometepe, but...
If all goes as planned and I can win the duel, it'd be quite the opportune moment to strike and take out the Ometepe tribe.
Today's duel number 6 for me. I'm really nervous because I cut my foot pretty badly.
cuts right on the outside of my foot. And so if it's one of those endurance challenges, it's going to be really, really difficult.
But God gave me this platform, and I'm going to do the best I can and hopefully come out with another victory.
The winner of today's duel will go back in the game.
Sarita drops out of the duel. Matt seizes the moment and will re-enter this game. Matt, congratulations. Six duels, six wins. You are back in this game. With the next tribal council, Redemption Island starts again. That means, Matt, you could be voted out again and sent right back here.
Guys, just please, give me a minute.
I'm absolutely stoked to be back in the game right now. I mean, I definitely think my time on Redemption Island gives me an advantage because I had six people break down everything that was going on in each tribe. Now I've got a couple of options. I can either go with Ometepe, I can go with Zapterra, but I gotta be careful because, I mean, one slip up out here and you're gone. I want to be in this game as long as I can. So I'm really just trying to figure out what's best for me and which route to take. Because last time I was coasting and waiting to play the game, and this time I can't be as near as passive because I'll be back on Redemption Island in a jiffy.
When you were blindsided, I had no idea. Let me
tell you this right now. Okay. Like right now, you are my closest
ally. Okay, good.
Like, because right now.
I didn't know where we stood. I didn't know what you were thinking.
Okay, this is what I want. I want to take out the Ometepe tribe. Because I'm honestly at the bottom of the alliance. I was thinking, like, we vote Steve out, and then we vote Philip out. Ometepe thinks everything's hunky-dory. And then that's when we blindside Rob.
Oh my god, I'm so nervous.
Just stop. Okay, just calm down and just hear me out. This game respects big moves.
Yeah.
It does. And this is a huge move.
Oh, right now.
We can only talk to each other about this.
You cannot.
What's going on? What are you reading over there?
Matthew, the story of Jesus' escape to Egypt.
Also forgot all about that.
Yeah. So Jesus fasted for 40 days and 40 nights.
Yeah.
About the same time as Survivor.
Yeah. And this may sound like crazy to y'all, but after I beat Stephanie, like it really kind of like clicked to me. I was like, God wanted me to win Redemption Island.
I really feel I was put here for a reason. And that reason was, I believe, to honor my God. So I'm morally conflicted here because I really genuinely care about everyone on the former Ometepe tribe. Part of me wants to do the big Survivor move. However, right now, I feel like my heart's almost telling me not to and just to stick with the Ometepe.
I've grown so much through that Redemption Island experience. And that is a time when I relied on God and I was tough.
This absolutely is a game. But my heart's telling me, don't change. I want to honor my God and be true to who I am. So I've decided I don't want to switch. I don't want to flip. And I'm just going to have peace with whatever happens. I mean, if it's God's will, he'll take me as far as he wants me to go.
Matt, vote for Grant, and I'll take you to the final three.
Top three, huh? It's not bad.
We're all getting ready to go to tribal council, and Mike slips me this note. This is my golden ticket to the final three. So here I am at the crossroads between keeping my word and breaking my word.
And what are you thinking? What are the possibilities that you would do something crazy tonight?
I mean, I don't want to at all, like, but this is my last chance.
Eighth person voted out of Survivor Redemption Island. Matt, you can bring me your torch.
What the hell, guys?
First and foremost, I'd like to congratulate myself on being the most naive person to ever play the game of Survivor. Fool me once, shame on you. Fool me twice, shame on me. So, I am reaping the benefits of my shame. I can't believe I got blindsided twice by the same people. Like, I feel like a moron. It's like it's the biggest practical joke in the world that's being played right now.
I'm trying to figure out what exactly your plan is, but I told you to stay here as long as you wanted me to, and I guess you wanted me to come back, and so here I am. I trust you that this is your will. You using my stupidity for your glory. So, thank you, Lord, for this opportunity, and blessed be your name.
Lord, but you want me to stay in it, God, I will fight
I can't sleep. I'm trying to figure out how I'm gonna pull myself up by my bootstraps and keep my sanity.
I want to show your glory to everyone, Lord, but I'm just such a broken man right now. I need you to protect my heart, Lord. I need you to protect my mind.
I had to lick my wounds and bleed for a little while and hurt, but I was ready to kind of get in the mindset of, all right, Redemption Island, part two, let's do it. And then, curveball.
God, my brother wouldn't quit. My dad wouldn't quit. You would never quit, Lord Jesus, and your spirit lives in me.
Matt, back-to-back blindsides. Where's your emotional state of mind right now?
I never knew that strangers could hurt me so deeply. I mean, I guess shame on me for letting them fool me twice, you know? I mean, it hurts, but ready to keep going if I can.
Matt does it. Mike and Matt stay alive.
This is unlike anything I've ever really experienced. Out here wasting away. Missing my family. I can only feel them when I really, really try. God has me here for a reason. I said this from the beginning, that God wanted me here. I don't know what the reason is for. I can't see that yet. But I know He wants me to be here. He's literally been... God has literally been carrying me through the past 4 days. I know I'm still in the game, but... I'm just so over this game.
Matt, 21 days on Redemption. Only 7 days in the regular game of Survivor. Where are you at with this? You've had an incredible roller coaster of emotions out here.
Just overwhelming peace about everything. I felt this need that if I kept winning, I could honor my God more and more. But He just kind of hit me with a lot of peace. And He was just like, you know, You've honored me enough, and if I go back, I go back, and if I go home, then I go home, and I'm at peace with that.
This is a very different Matt than I've seen in the past. It sounds to me like you're ready to go home.
I'm gonna do the best I can in today's challenge, but yeah, I think I'm ready to go home. The only reason I was staying in this game is because I thought there's more of God's will to accomplish, and I felt like I've accomplished what I came here to do. So whatever happens, I'm ready for it.
God is not done talking to Matt. Matt has 3 pucks in the end zone. You are staying alive on Redemption Island, whether you want to be here or not. So Matt, are you frustrated with your God right now?
I mean, you just got to be accepting. I guess He still wants me here for some reason, so I told Him I'd stay here as long as He wanted me to.
How many days did Jesus fast?
40.
Interesting, our game is 39 days.
Yeah, 39, 40 days.
Doing well so far.
Hey, Matt, it's Bert. Just want to say, love you. Hope you're healthy, hope you're staying strong.
I just see my brother, and I'm just thinking, I just want to die right there, just seeing him. It makes every struggle, every hard time that I've gone through on Redemption Island completely worth it.
3.
Matt stays alive.
Andrea showed up at the Isle of Redemption. I was certainly most hurt by her, considering I was like, you're my number one, I want to take you to the top, let's go to the end. And then she turns around and writes my name down because she's scared to make a move with me.
Yeah. Matt has it right. Andrea has it right. Matt, Mike, and Andrea, stay alive.
I feel so great right now. I mean, I love this place. It's become home to me. This is day 29 for me. I remember coming here that first night and it raining, thinking, how am I ever gonna get through this? I was extremely bitter and upset and angry, but you know, those feelings came to pass because this is just a special place. Dear Lord, thank you so much for this morning. Thank you for Redemption Island and what it's done and meant to all of us. Help us to dig as deeply as we can, but know that your will is perfect and have peace with whatever the outcome is, Lord. Thank you so much for your son, and we love you. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen.
2 blindsides, 7 days in an actual game of Survivor, 11 duels, 29 days on Redemption Island. That's pretty unbelievable. God deserves all the glory and all the credit
My faith has grown. I've grown as a person. I mean, who knew what a treasure awaited on Redemption Island?
And with that, Matt is out of this challenge and out of this game. After 36 days in this game, survived 10 duels, but fell short when you needed it most, Matt is the sixth member of the jury, has shot at winning. Matt, you no longer have a shot at the money, but you, too, will have a say in who wins this game. Matt, you become the sixth member of the jury. Take off your buff, put it in the urn, I'll see you at Tribal Council.
You got it. See y'all later, Jeff.
Burn, baby. See y'all later.
See ya.
In 36 days in the game and 29 days on Redemption Island, God was with me every step of the way, and I think his will was ultimately done, and I praise his name for just letting me be a vessel for him. That's been my reward for all the struggle and all the strife that I've been through.